All right, welcome everybody. Today I'm going to be playing Blue Black Pirate Tempo. Supposed to be sort of like the Mono Blue Tempo, but with a pirate theme. The idea behind it is you sacrifice the consistency of the mana base that Mono Blue has, and you sacrifice the absolute nut draw of like turn one unblockable, turn two protection, and Curious Obsession for a slightly better mid-range approach. So you have like better chance versus aggro. Better chance versus control kind of idea in the late game. So like if you don't get the nuts, you have a better chance of winning. So slight consistency upgrade. So with that, we sort of keep the whole Curious Obsession dive down Storm Tamer approach, but then we start to get really interesting in the two drops. So in the two drops, we have Dire Fleet Poisoner, which is a flash pirate with death touch. And when it enters the battlefield, target attacking pirate you control gets 1/1 and gains death touch until end of turn, allowing us to trade up our smaller pirates into bigger opposing threats. If our opponent puts something out that will block effectively, we can kill it. We have Fathom Fleet Captain, which will produce tons and tons of pirates with menace, theoretically. We have Freebooter as sort of our first hand hate spell as a way to snatch wraths out of our opponent's hand, ways to play around Settle the Wreckage and Cleansing Nova. Same with Thought Erasure, it's just a good card. In the grand scheme of things, I think Thought Erasure is not a good card. In standard, it's pretty decent right now. So we might actually want this to be a duress. I'm not totally certain. We have Lookout's Dispersal, just a better mana leak in this deck, so it seems pretty good. Ruin Raider, effectively just Dark Confidant, but for 3 mana and with slightly better stats than standard, that seems really sweet. Thief of Sanity? Thief of Sanity, best pirate, no questions asked. Hashta's Chaker, good removal on a body, and then generic blue-black lands. Sideboard, we have some trackers in case we need some Grave Hate. We have Disdainful Stroke versus our opponents wanting to cast big things. Negates versus Control. Cast Downs and Moments of Craving versus aggro. Plaguecrafter because he's a good card. And one more Hostage Taker in case we need him. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take this into some constructed events, I guess. Or ranked. We'll do ranked. Let's do a constructed event. We'll do a constructed event. All right, here we go. Watery Grave, Watery Grave, and tons of two drops. That seems pretty decent. No one drop to start, unfortunately, but we'll be doing a lot this game. Let's see what our opponent's on. Steam Vents and untapped. All right. Let's pay two life and freeboot. Opponent has a Shivan Fire. Well, at least we get to peek at our opponent's hand here. Syncopate, Growth Spiral, Niv-Mizzet. Alrighty. I guess we'll take Syncopate, but it's not like it actually does anything. Opponent gets it back. So we will definitely, given the option, we would Thought Erasure this Niv-Mizzet, but that would never resolve. So we're going to pass, stop on our opponent's end step, and flash in a Dire Fleet Poisoner. Get the aggro train rolling. Opponent plays a search for his Kanta. Awesome. Well, we draw an island, which lets us play a Storm Tamer. We also get to Thought Erasure our opponent. Take Niv-Mizzet. Do we want the swamp? Yes, we do want the swamp. Go attacking. Pass the turn. Now, our opponent does have a bunch of counter spells, but they have no threats in hand. three cards in the graveyard. They didn't mill with Search. I'm going to Growth Spiral, trying to hit a land. Okay, plays a Steam Vents tapped. We untap, we draw the Swamp. So they have a Syncopate for one, or a Sinister Sabotage. All right. We'll go attacking. Deal three. Play a Swamp. Play Ruin Raider. They shouldn't have a counter spell that hits this. They don't. All right. Start bobbing. Opponent gets a Search for his content. Does not mill. Explosion, X1. We will counter. We do not want our opponent to draw a card. Did that not... Oh, it no longer targets a spell or permanent we control. Well then. Let's freeboot. Opponent did draw a Niv-Mizzet. We will take Syncopate. Go to combat, go to attacks, attack. Flash in Poisoner. We want this extra damage here. Go to blocks, slash damage. Play Watergrave untapped, pass the turn, Ruin Raider. Get a dive down. So even if our opponent makes it to their sixth land and plays Niv-Mizzet, they should die. But it mills a Wilderness Reclamation, plays a land, plays Niv-Mizzet, and that should be game over. Gotcha. All right. Next round. I forgot constructed events were best of one, honestly. I thought I was going to be playing best of threes, but... turns out Arena doesn't like it when you play best of threes, I guess. Island Drowned Catacombs, excellent start. Bunch of two drops. This looks like a great hand. Opponent starts Mountain Fanatical Firebrand. Start Island Storm Tamer. This Fathom Fleet Captain is less than ideal, I think. I think I'm actually okay blocking this. You know, actually, no, we're not going to block. No, we're playing a 1-2 next turn, so. Second Fanatical Firebrand shoots the Storm Tamer anyway. Is our opponent stuck on one land? Oh my gosh, they're stuck on one land. All right, well, let's freeboot. What you got in your hand that makes this good? Lots of lightning bolts. Holy crap. Let's take Lava Coil because it's creature only damage. That way they have to use something that could go to our face to kill it. So we'll take Lava Coil. Pass the turn. Opponent shocks. Gets back Lava Coil. Goes attacking. We go to 17. We untap. We draw another freebooter. We'll play Drowned Catacomb. Do they have any more one mana burn that we know about? They do not. In that case, I guess let's. Yeah, we'll freeboot. Well, experimental frenzy, they are light years away from casting. We'll take lava coil again. Same plan. Opponent going to shoot our face. Spectacle Bolt. Light up the stage. Desperate for lands. No lands. Alright. Well, I don't like losing life, but we are going to play Ruin Raider. We do need to close this game out faster, and we need to draw lands. So hopefully we don't just start wheeling into four drops. It's a dive down. Dive down is useful. Dive down is a one mana counter spell for stuff that our opponent intends on doing. I wonder if our opponent's playing the 13 land burn list. I saw some guy playing literally a 13 land burn list because the way the arena shuffler like modifies your draws, it's kind of busted. We're gonna play Fathom Fleet Captain. Get in for three, go with dive down. Pass the turn. Ruin Raider finds us, Thief of Sanity. We really need some lands. Opponent plays a Gitu Lava Runner. Does not attack. We untap, we draw a land. Play a land. Now let's just attack. Pay two. Go to damage. Let's just pass. No reason to play anything else at the moment. It's a land. Woo! No life loss. Yeah, our opponent's got to be playing 13 land burn. Which, if they're trying to manipulate the draws in MTG Arena with Arena Shuffler, then they deserve to lose every time. But so far, this deck performing pretty well. Very, very happy with its performance. Right, yeah, we got a Curious Obsession this time. Seems sweet. Oh, put a mulligan. That's good news for us. Start Island, pass the turn. One plays a Mountain and a Firebrand. Another mono red. Gets in for one. We untap. Play Drowned Catacomb. Start Freebooting. Steamkin, Pyromancer. So risk factors are only target. That's good. That's no removal for Freebooter yet. They'd have to top deck into it. And next turn, we can land a Curious Obsession on it and protect it with Dive Down. Oh, that feels dirty. You have to have drawn removal for it right now. Opponent plays a Mountain, plays a Steamkin, does not have removal for Freebooter. We draw a Watery Grave, play an Island, Curious Obsession. Go to combat. Go to attackers. Attack. We draw a card. Ruin Raider. All right. Pass the turn. Opponent plays a Mountain, plays a Steamkin. Counter on Steamkin. Goes to attackers. Attacks for three. We take three, go to our turn, draw an island. Play a swamp, play Ruin Raider. Let's get as greedy as possible here. Attack for two, do the damage, take the action, draw an island, Fast to our end step. What does Ruin Raider find us? A thief of sanity. So kind of unfortunate there. But opponent plays a Lava Runner, counters on everything. Opponent Lightning Strikes. Well, we dive down. If they attack, we gotta take out the Steamkin with only two counters. And if they don't attack, I'm gonna be very confused. Okay, opponent plays a Pyromancer. Deals two to us. Doesn't attack. Holy crap. Okay. We'll go to combat. Attack for two. Take the action. Draw Lookout's Dispersal. That's pretty good. Play an island. Play Thief of Sanity. I think we're going to pass with Lookout's Dispersal up. We draw Fathom Fleet. We're going to drop off Ruin Raider here. Take six. We have a counter spell to protect us from basically anything else. Can't risk any more life loss at this point in the game. Another Thief. All right. Let's go attacking. See if we can't pick up more stuff to use as removal. Skewer the Critic's Lightning Strike Mountain. Take Skewer. Play an island. Skewer Lava Runner. Play a Fathom Fleet, Captain. Pass the turn. Opponent attacks with Steamkin. Block with a captain. Untap, draw a swamp. Play a swamp. Attack with, I think, just the thief again. Take Pyromancer. A good chump blocker, so play the Pyromancer. Shoot our opponent. Play Thief. Pass the turn. Hopefully they don't just have two burn spells. Opponent shocks. Oh, we can't even counter that. Unless they're not paying attention. Okay, they're paying attention. Oh, that's unfortunate. We didn't really have a way around that, though. All right, Pona gets us. All right, two wins, one loss. Round four. One drop into Curious Obsession with Dive Down backup. That seems like the nuts to me. So, I mean, we're going to keep. Opponent starts Mountain. We'll start Storm Tamer. Maybe we should have waited. We probably should have waited. Mountain number two, Runaway Steamkin. Well, let's Thought Erasure. We will take... probably... Pyromaster? Yeah, let's take Pyromaster. Dire Fleet Poisoner, we will leave on top. We do need some guys. Plays a land, risk factor, counter on Steamkin. Yeah, we'll take the damage here. Opponent hits us for two. We draw Poisoner. Play Drowned Catacomb. Thought Erasure our opponent. If we can just stymie our opponent's damage output here. Swamp to the grave. Stymie their card advantage, basically. We can tank the damage and stop them from drawing tons and tons of cards. Opponent hardcasts Wizard's Lightning. Attacks for three. We untap and draw Thief of Sanity. So play an island. Pass the turn. Steamkin number two. Flash in Poisoner. Block. Opponent just wants to do damage. They're going to keep the risk factor. Okay, if we dive down, they're just going to risk factor with the mana, so we're going to let the damage happen. All right, another Poisoner. So let's go Thief of Sanity here. Pass the turn. Opponent casts a risk factor. Gets a counter. They pitched a land. Okay, we're going to take the damage and go to four. Okay, we're diving down so we have a good blocker. Okay, opponent only has one card in hand, no risk factors in the grave. We are going to Curious Obsession. Okay, we're going to go attack. Thief last. Draw first. Okay. It's important to do it in that order, so that way you have the most information about your cards when you pick cards from your opponent's deck. That's really bad, actually. We hit four lands across two triggers here. So we're going to play a Watery Grave tapped. Pass the turn. As long as our opponent doesn't have two burn spells, we should be fine. They give up. Sweet. Three wins, one loss. Round five. We have one 2-drop with a Lookout's Dispersal. We're going to keep this because Thief of Sanity and Ruin Raiders are so strong. Also, have we only played aggro deck? No, we played a couple. Just feels like it because the last two have been mono red. Or like the last three have been mono red. Oh my god, is it just mono red? Plays a mountain, plays a runaway steamkin. Oh, we're gonna get a free kill on this lava runner. That's awesome. Oh, so good. All right, Curious Obsession. Attack for 3. Oh, this feels amazing. Completely punish our opponent. Bring that in untapped, so we have Lookout's Dispersal at the ready. Opponent plays a mountain. Wizard's Lightning, huh? Well, we're just going to dive down. I want to save Lookout's Dispersal for potentially a threat. Alright. Get in for 3. Draw a card. Storm Tamer, huh? We're gonna play Storm Tamer so we can leave up Dispersal. I guess it may have been correct to use the Lookout's Dispersal and keep the dive down just in case we needed a one mana counter so we could play a 3-drop that turn if we drew a land. Something to note for future plays. It worked out all right because we're awesome, but like probably not the correct play. Opponent casts a Light Up the Stage. All right, we'll let it go. Opponent finds another Light Up the Stage and a Shock. It casts another Light Up the Stage. We will disperse that one. Before the trigger resolves, so they can't just pay the mana for it. So opponent does have 4 mana if they want to play a couple of kill spells here. Kind of unfortunate that we can't really do anything about that, but it does shrink their guy. Now, if they have 3 1-mana spells, they're going to cast a lot of spells this turn. Opponent shocks the Poisoner. Okay, they have another shock. Kills the Poisoner. Experimental Frenzy. Well, time to test our opponent's luck. Play Ruin Raider, get in for 1. We draw a land. Perfect. So opponent can no longer play cards from their hand. So let's test their running. They play a Firebrand. They play a Firebrand. Play a land. And a Pyromancer. Shoot us in the face. Legion War Boss? Oh god. They're gonna sack both their Firebrands to kill the Ruin Raider? You cannot believe how much this hurts right now. Yeah, we're pretty effectually dead. So, I'm going to go ahead and scoop this one up. I don't see a way we could ever possibly dig ourselves out of this mess. All right. 3 wins, 2 losses, round 6. All right, we have 2 mana, 2 2-drops, a dive down, and a Thief of Sanity. This hand looks crazy good. We're going to keep. Draw a 3rd land, it's going to be even better. Okay, cool. When it plays an overgrown tune, we're going to start Water Grave Tapped. Flash Pirate feels really good, by the way. Especially one with Death Touch. It's basically a kill spell on a body. Ah, this appears to be the Explorer deck. I'll play Drowned Catacomb. Go freebooting. Vraska Golgari Queen. And we'll take that one. Opponent is at least one turn off removing this, unless they just drew three mana removal. Okay, opponent plays a tap land and a land or else. We draw an island. So we're going to play an island and get in for one. Pass the turn. Opponent plays a Woodland Cemetery. Goes attacking. Flash in Direfleet Poisoner. Oh, this is the second time this has happened. So good. Oh, dang, that's dirty. I love it. Alright, opponent has to play something that kills spells. Okay. Let it resolve, see what they target. We're gonna say no. We draw Curious Obsession. That's also sweet. So let's see. We'll play Watery Grave Untapped. Play Thief of Sanity. And get in for one. Pass the turn. If our opponent plays like Vivian Minus, they might be a little sad. Looks like they're going to try and Krasis for X4 to draw two cards, gain two life. Okay. The fact that that's a cast... Oh, they only did it X3. That's a lot worse than 4. Like, a lot worse than 4. Okay, and go back to our turn. Okay, that's good. Now we're going to Hostage Taker Krasis, because if they kill Hostage Taker, they get back a 0/0. If we get the opportunity to cast Krasis, it's going to be crazy. So get in the air. Get that sweet, sweet thief value. The opponent gives up. Oh, this deck does some nasty stuff. And people play into these cards. It tells me that people don't see them very often. We've killed 2-1 power creatures for free with Direfleet Poisoner because our opponent did not expect it. The card itself having Death Touch and then granting Death Touch on top of it is just good. Alright, yeah, we've got Obsession, 1-drop, 2-drop, the lands to cast everything. This is amazing. Start Storm Tamer. Opponent starts Lava Runner. Okay, we get a freebooter. So let's play a swamp. Go attacking. Pass the turn. We might get the poisoner kill again. Yeah, let's do it. Oh, now if they want to kill it, they have to waste a burn spell. Steamkin. Alright. Ooh, Obsession 2. That feels good. Play Obsession. We're going to aggro our opponent down here. Draw a card. Okay. Awesome. We've got Dispersal, in case of anything too crazy here. Viashino Pyromancer for our opponent. Yeah, we'll take the damage. Okay, we will counter Light up the stage. That's not allowed. Opponent gets in for three. We untap, draw Fathom Fleet Captain. Play another Obsession on Storm Tamer. Go attacking. Incentivize our opponent to block. They don't. Alright. Draw two. Play an island. Freeboot. No legal targets. Opponent kind of running out of gas. We also inadvertently played around Chain Whirler, which is pretty sweet. Opponent plays another Steamkin, powers up this Steamkin all the way. We can kill Pyromancer. We can chump Runaway Steamkin. Let's chump, because that way, if they take the counters off, they kill the Steamkin, if they're not paying attention. Yep, just like that. Well, now they gotta play Chain Whirler. Sweet, we traded a 1-2 for a 4-4. Like, you don't get to do that very often. Okay. Attack in the air. Draw a card. Lookout's Dispersal. Play a swamp. Play Fathom Fleet. Pass the turn. Opponent plays a land. Oh, we can counter everything but a shock, I think, at this point. We're going to take the damage. Counter the lightning strike. Take six. Go to six. Untap. Fathom Fleet's good. Attack with everything. Pay two. Make a pirate. Good for chumping. That guy has menace too. That's sweet. Okay, we're gonna draw some cards. Another Curious Obsession. Thief of Sanity. We'll play an island. Since we can only play one more blocker anyway, we're gonna play Thief of Sanity just in case our opponent draws another Chain Whirler. And we're just going to chump whatever lets us stay alive. I think they have to attack with everything and then have more burn on top of that. So chump and chump. We're going to take two. They'd have to risk factor into shock shock to win, I think. Okay, opponent Shock Storm Tamer. And that's it. Sweet, we got him! Feels good, man. Getting Icy Manipulator. Alright, 5-2. Round eight. No black mana. This is the first kind of awkward mana hand we've had, but we do have a Curious Obsession, so hopefully that gets us there. It should. Curious Obsession and one drop. Start one drop. Opponent Breeding Pool, Llanowar Elves. Curious Obsession. Start doing the damage. Heck yeah, I'm gonna draw cards. Draw Fathom Fleet Captain. Opponent plays a Watery Grave tapped into a Wild Growth Walker. Okay. This time we're gonna attack first just to see if we can draw black mana prior. Okay, Lookout's Dispersal. Really not bad here. Opponent plays a Branch Walker. I'm actually going to disperse this. Our opponent would have to be holding black land and like Assassin's Trophy or cast down to deal with Storm Tamer. Okay, opponent gets in for two. Yeah. Start building Curious Obsession, Tron. Okay, draw two. Black land, please. Still no black mana. Oh, but we have the third Curious Obsession. Opponent casts a Hydroid Krasis for one, just to stop the beats, to try and stop the bleeding. All right, we're going to attack. Opponent chumps, just so we don't draw cards. We'll pass. Oh, if we ever draw black mana. Okay, opponent shocks. Probably has a Vraska's Contempt. Oh no, Krasis for two to draw a card and gain one life. Gets in for one. We untap. We draw Thief of Sanity. Go attacking. Opponent chumps. We either cast Curious Obsession or pass and discard. If we discard, we show them we're missing mana. If we cast Curious Obsession, there's no way they don't have a removal spell for it. And I want to save this Curious Obsession. This is actually really tough. I'm going to pass, and we're going to discard Thought Erasure. Hopefully they don't have removal this turn. If they somehow don't, we're, like, golden. Opponent gets in for one. Passes. On our upkeep, Vraska's Contempt. Okay. Well, we're going to sack Storm Tamer to prevent them from gaining life. We draw an island. This is probably justice for playing this deck, because this deck is really nasty. Like, any sort of Curious Obsession deck in Standard is one of the worst play experiences when you're on the receiving end of it. So I'm okay with this being karmic justice if this is how we die. However, I am going to still attempt to kill my opponent. Oh my god. We've drawn so many cards. And still no... no black mana. We've seen 13 cards and haven't been able to find a single black mana. An opponent just resolved a Planeswalker. That's really, really bad. On a scale of 1 to awful, that's less than great. Gets in for one. I guess we pass. Discard another Fathom Fleet. Oh, so brutal. We aren't running the maximum duels that you could run. But that's because we're a tempo deck or an aggro deck. We really want to have as many untapped lands as possible. So we are only running one tapped blue-black duel. We are running four Drowned Catacomb and four Watery Grave. So the odds of this happening are actually astronomical. But we are very quickly getting to the point where we will not be able to recover. Okay, opponent is gaining too much life and drawing too many cards. It's not like we have any Wraths in the main deck because that would be counterproductive. Anything we play at this point will pretty much have to chump. I mean, we're not winning is the problem. By doing anything that I'm doing right now, we're not winning. And we're not going to be able to prevent Vivian Reid from ulting. Didn't see black mana until like turn eight and still almost killed our opponent. I'm going to put that down as a mark in our deck's favor because that was really unlikely. So we get three cards with at least one rare and some gold. So, first card, Inescapable Blaze. Second card, Lingering Phantom. And third card, the rare, is Gigantosaurus. Gotta build that devotion to green. All right. Oh, wait, do we have any packs? We do have a pack. So we'll open up our reward pack. See what we get. It's a rare wild card, the best rare. All right. Well, if you enjoyed Pirates, if you enjoyed this deck, let me know down in the comments below. Consider subscribing to the channel if you've made it this far. And I think you're all wonderful people, and I thank you for supporting this channel. Thanks for watching my videos. If you have any ideas for decks you want to see me play, feel free to leave them a link to them in the comment below, or send me them to the email address that I'll either have on screen or in the description below. Thank you so much again for watching, and I hope you have a good day. Bye!